Hello friends, welcome back to Arth Vimarsh. So far we have been talking about the preferences in the third chapter, and we have understood that there are underlying assumptions which are there when we try to understand the consumer preferences. So the key assumptions which we have discussed were the completeness, the reflexivity and the transitivity. So given these set of assumptions, today we are moving to the notion of indifference curves. So in this video we are going to answer two key questions, that is, what are indifference curves and why cannot they intersect. So we must understand this thing, that what's the need for understanding these indifference curves. So basically this is one of the most convenient way in which we can describe the preferences graphically. Okay, so by constructing an indifference curve, we basically are plotting the preferences of the consumers. So indifference curves are basically the preference maps which we try to plot on the graph to understand what consumer preferences are. So to define it technically, it represents all the combinations of the market baskets. What do we mean by market baskets? Is the bundle of goods which a consumer is choosing. Say for example, we have assumed here X1 and X2 in the figure. So the market basket combinations which provide to the consumer same level of satisfaction. Now any combination of X1, X2, okay, which provides same level of satisfaction, say for example K level of satisfaction in terms of numbers if I talk about, okay. So say for example U is the utility which person derives by consuming X1, okay, X1 plus X2 combination, and X1, X2 can take any value in such a way that any combination of X1 and X2, for example, if this is 4, this is 3 units, this is 5 units, this is 2 units, I mean all the whatever combination is going to be there, if that combination is lying on this plot, that is going to give equal amount of satisfaction to the consumer, and consumer can choose any of the combination, be it combination A, be it B, be it C, be it D, E, F or the G which he had chosen, okay, any of the combination is going to yield him equal utility. So this is what it means. Now the shaded region which you can observe here in the gray color in the figure, so what it implies is the bundles which are weakly preferred. Remember what we mean by weakly preferred? It was less preferred, right? Weakly preferred. So whatever point is going to be there in the shaded region, so say for example in the shaded region we have a point like L or M or N, okay, these points are there, okay, and these points obviously they are not feasible, we know that. So a consumer obviously cannot afford to have these combination of goods, right? For X1, X2 combination, I mean these bundles L, M and N. So they are weakly preferred, right? So this is called weakly preferred set, which has been shaded here above the indifference curve. And the bundles on the boundary, if you observe, of this set, okay, the bundles for which the consumer is just indifferent to X1 and X2, like I have mentioned here from A to F, they form the indifference curve. Now, given that what indifference curves are, so also to define what are indifference maps, always remember that the graph which we have talked about, right, containing this indifference curve. So this is containing a set of indifference curves which show the market baskets among which a consumer is indifferent, right? So this we also term as the indifference map. So wherever you come across this term indifference map, so it is basically talking about this graph for indifference curve only. Now the point here I would like to emphasize here is that indifference curves don't show you which bundles are better and which bundles are worse. So if a consumer has to decide that, for example, if the bundle, for example, A, B, C or F or any of the A to F bundles, which one is better? So you cannot tell actually. You just can say that yes, they are going to provide you equal utility, but you cannot clearly, I mean, get any insight of which one is better actually, right? And we, I mean, it's very quite, it's quite intuitive to think of also, because yes, as per the preferences, we are having these combinations which are giving us equal level of satisfaction or the utility. But they are nowhere showing us which bundle is better when we are having this plot. So the plot of indifference curve, it do not tell us which consumption bundle is better or which is worse, right? So please note this point. Now, given the assumptions about the consumer preferences, which we had already discussed, that of completeness, reflexivity, and transitivity, so we have another assumption about the consumer preferences to make the understanding simpler when we are dealing with the consumer choice relations. So the assumption is that the indifference curve, so the assumption is that the indifference curves cannot intersect, okay, because they are representing distinct level of preferences, so they cannot intersect. Now, how to prove this thing? So in the figure, you should observe that there are three bundles which a consumer is going to choose from, that is X, Y, and Z, okay. Now, these bundles are in such a way that X lies only on one indifference curve, like you can observe. Say for example, this is I1, okay, and this is I2, indifference curve 2. So X is lying on the indifference curve I1, right? And Y, if you observe, it's lying on the different indifference curve, that is I2, right? And Z, if you observe, it's lying at the point of intersection. So it's lying both on I1 and I2. But by assumption, the indifference curves represent distinct level of preferences, right? So one of the bundles, say for example, X, okay? So say for example, X is strictly preferred over the other bundle, Y. Okay, so we know that X is also indifferent to Z, right? If you observe from the figure, so X is on the same indifference curve as that of Z, that is on I1. So X is indifferent to Z, and also observe that Z is indifferent to Y. Both are lying on the same indifference curve, that is I2, right? So X is indifferent to Z, and Z is indifferent to Y. And the axiom of transitivity, if you remember, it will imply from this relation that, from the relation of transitivity, we have X being indifferent to Y, right? But isn't this a contradiction? Why? Because observe that the assumption is contradicting, okay? Contradicting that X is preferred over Y strictly, right? We had assumed this, right? We had assumed this. I mean, not even assumed, like if you can observe from the graph also, right? So X was strictly preferred over Y, but now we are arriving at the conclusion that X is indifferent to Y. So this itself is a contradiction, right? So by contradiction, we establish that the indifference curves representing distinct level of preferences cannot cross. So this is what the key takeaway we have from this slide. Now let's move further. Now just as a proof, if you observe in this slide that we already discussed in the previous section, is the contradiction which we have discussed in detail. So I have just jotted down the steps how we went about proving that they cannot intersect. And in many of the academia, evaluations, or even in the professional entrance examinations, you can come across the application of this concept. Where the key intuition is to identify whether, you are able to answer based on this concept that indifference curves cannot intersect. I mean, this is one of the key property which follows throughout the microeconomics when any consumer based application is there from the consumer theory. So this is about the indifference curves and how to go about the proof that indifference curves cannot. So thank you for your patient listening. The key takeaway from today's discussion is that indifference curves basically are the maps for plotting the preferences of the consumer. And these preferences, when they are being plotted, the indifference curves which are generated, they have this property that they cannot intersect, okay? So this also we have proved. So thank you again for your patient listening. And in the next video, we will be discussing few examples on the preference maps, that is the indifference curves. like the perfect substitutes, perfect complements, what are goods, what are bads, what is non-satiation or what is satiation. These concepts have wide variety of applications throughout the consumer theory in whole microeconomics, and we'll also discuss the concept of marginal rate of substitutions. So thanks again. See you next time.